Ladies and gentlemen, here to present the Badge of Merit for Faith is Dr. Chief Najeel Bigpond of the Yuchi Tribe of Oklahoma.
Sangala San, it's an honor to stand here before you and see so many people. I believe you're in a position of honor as well. You're to be honored for just coming to an event such as this. Real quickly, before I introduce and tell you about a great man, Pastor C.L. Jackson, I would like to give you a quick brief of what honor means to Native American people. The word honor is a word that is like a precious stone. It's a sweet fragrance. It's a sweet wind that blows from the north to the south. Honor is a warrior that is able and capable of keeping its word, keeping his promise or her promise. There's a word that our Yuchis people sung on the Trail of Tears. That's a song. It says, always go forward, never look back. Hele agano, hele ofene. And we shall never look back at the past. From this day on, we should be looking forward to the great things, the great awakening, the great revival that we prayed for. It's an honor for a Native American to introduce one of our great black leaders, a covenant warrior of God, a peacemaker, one who's able to keep peace and not start wars. I would say this to America, Ninzo Detalyut. Ninzo Detalyut is the Yuchi word meaning you're like a river that gives me life. And without you, I cannot exist. Pastor C.L. Jackson pastors the Pleasant Grove Mission Baptist Church of Houston, Texas, for 45 years. Him and his wife, Betty, for 53 years, kept covenant. Pastor Jackson has been in ministries for 50 years. He's a leader, traditional values, family values. He's appointed by Governor Rick Perry to Texas, from Texas to the Texas Department of Criminal Justice. He was in the Morehouse College into the Hall of Preachers, appointed to the Hall of Preachers for his several books that he's wrote in his life's work, over 18 books. So one of the first preachers, or if the first preacher to have a weekly TV program, a down-to-earth minister that speaks the truth in honesty. He's planted over 19 churches just in the Houston area. When Martin Luther King came to Washington to give the speech, I had a dream speech. He said to my right, listen to this great man at the corner of the reflecting pool, and listen to a great man of honor wanting to see all people, black, white, red, yellow, whatever color, to come to know God, could come to know unity. People, when we work together in unity, we can move as a unit and we'll be in union. That is a covenant. Many times we have misunderstandings of covenant. We have to be a covenant warriors in Christ. I stand here before you. I'm a fourth generation pastor. They are warriors. My father, in World War II, over five major battles in Africa and Germany, European wars. My brother in Vietnam, three tours. So I'm proud of the military warriors of Christ, men and women. I'm proud that we can say, Nenzo Detaliut, America. In other words, America, you're like a river that gives us life. And without you, we cannot exist. And that is the reason we're here today to honor such a man as Pastor C.L. Jackson, a great brother in Christ. I have a dream also that all men, black, white, yellow, whatever color, that the red man, the Native American people, will come to give honor, to come out of the woods, to come out of the reservations, over 365 tribes, to come out of those reservations and become to give honor to God where honor is due. That is my dream. But all our people would come to know Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. So at this time, we're here to honor Pastor C.L. Jackson. Would you give the Lord a hand of praise?
To this most magnificent audience that God brought us here through this bright young, I call him servant of God, son of God, Glenn Beck. And not only him, but Babe Barton and all of you. Some 48 years ago, right over here beyond the fence, I stood as a young man who was led here by God and Martin Luther King. Stood right over there. My first trip here to Washington, the first trip on a bus to go through Mississippi, which they dared us to come because they promised us they would blow the bus up. And we came and served, and I was in the sermon Dr. Martin Luther King preached, I Have a Dream. Thank you. But let me say this. Can I get out of your hair? God sent his son to this earth so that we could all gather. And I think that's the dream and the vision of Glenn Beck. And you would have to wonder, what was the audience participation, what would they give back? I saw him, Glenn Beck, eyes full of tears as he said what they have given for all of this to happen. So what will Jesus, if he stood here right now, what would be expected of this great audience? And when you study, you're going to see where there were three women in the ministry of Jesus Christ. Now, you know, there was many, very many, many men, many children, but there were three classical women stood out in his ministry. just like you stand out in the ministry of Dr. Glenn Beck. One of those women came and gave two mites. She said she gave all she had, which was two mites. We call them in the Bible the widow mite. She gave them as a gift. When Jesus gave the offering, she gave all she had, and it was so powerful until Jesus stopped the offering and said, this woman will be remembered because her name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life. And I came to tell you, you didn't come for nothing. You came to give your gift, which would be a gift of yourself. But that was another great woman. This woman gave the best she had, which was a box of anointment. She anointed Jesus' feet. Can you imagine? This woman went down and got at his feet. She didn't anoint his head, didn't anoint his hand, didn't anoint his body, but the what? The feet. And took her long silk hair, wiped the feet clean, and kissed his feet with her antiseptic mouth. What a great gift. And Jesus said, this shall be remembered. Because she gave him a resurrection before he even died. You can do the same. You can pray, give the best you have for a young man named Glenn Beck. And thirdly, and I close, I'm gonna walk back. There was another great woman, just like you, just like you. She was not Jewish. She was Greek. She was like you and I, a Gentile. She was not supposed to be in the crowd. But she came. She followed Jesus on behalf of her daughter who had an unclean spirit. Didn't have no money. But God's son, Jesus Christ, said, he had not seen that kind of faith in her as he had seen in the Israelites. And do you know what? When she got to Jesus, even the disciples told her she was not included. And when she spoke to Jesus in a begging voice, he ignored her. He would not say a word. And then when Jesus spoke, he said, should I take the bread from the table of the children and give it to a dog? She didn't get upset. She did not panic. She said, you're right, but even the dog is due crumbs. There's somebody here living on crumbs. I looked at my man, his hands. There are people come from Iraq and all around, from Afghanistan on different legs. But I think they can give a crumb. They can give all they have. She said, but feed the dog underneath the table. And I close. I want to thank Glenn Beck for giving a person of mine, a man, that don't deserve to be here. I quit school in the 10th grade, but God never let me stop. I have a bachelor degree, I have a PhD, and then I have a doctor of law because God would not let me stop. He fed me underneath the table.